Alright, welcome back to the Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Let's Play. I was about to say Rechain of Memories for a second, but then I realized I do not have my collaborators with me right here. So, there's that. Is that Terra or is that Ventus? I can't tell.
Terra.
That's Terra, never mind. Where I can't recognize that butt. I remember Terra, like, in his, like, Power Ranger form had, like, a very firm-looking butt. Then Ventus is just... Ventus is, like, well, he looks small, so that's easy to distinguish him for, and... Aqua's a girl. So, that's one way to distinguish between characters in their suit form. I think before, like, I was complaining about, like, how, like, they all look the same, because I couldn't tell, like, between the characters. But, yeah, after playing it a little, I was like, okay, I'm used to what every character looks like now in their Power Ranger form. I forgot what's called, I'm just gonna call them a Power Ranger form, because that's what they look like. So, we're on to Radiant Garden. Oh yeah, this is the place where I'm guessing all of us finally meet, right? Ventus and Terra alike. Friends. God, I feel like I want to talk about more of my history of gaming. I discussed that I grew up with the Nintendo 64 and the GameCube. Nintendo was pretty much my first gaming console. But because of that, like, our family was not that rich. So, like... Or at least, like, they did, my parents didn't really give me a whole lot of money. I mean, we're still not rich at all, despite the game collection that you guys thought that I might have owned. But, yeah, all that's just from my allowance money.
Excuse me.
Usually I just skip lunch and
I'm terribly sorry to bother
buy games.
You,
yeah. And when there's, like, a newly game release game that's coming out, I usually save up my money.
I'd be pleased as punch to help you, if I can.
I mean, now that I have a job, I don't have to worry about it that
I'm
much, but at the same time, it's like...
Around here.
It's still, there's, like,
have
a lot of games.
It?
Like, I know there's Horizon Zero Dawn,
I
guess
what
it's called. Zero Horizon Dawn, I'm not
he
sure.
He scampered off toward yon castle right hurry.
But aside from that...
Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah, there's also Nier Automata. I really want to play that game, but the reason why I haven't yet is because, one, I still haven't beaten the Nier game yet
Terra.
For my Let's Play.
I hope you're
and
still there.
And two, again, money. So I was like, I can't really, like, do much for that. Anyways, yeah, grew up with the GameCube. I owned a Wii, and after that I was like, oh, there's, like, no Wii games coming out. Like, I think I got Mario Galaxy and The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. I think that was, like, my extent to, like, my Wii library. Like, I never grew up with Metroid, there was no Star Fox game, no F-Zero game, I don't think, like, there was any other, like, Nintendo stuff. Oh, aside from Kirby, though, I remember I was a huge fan of Kirby when I was playing on the N64 game. And I was like, oh, I really want to play a Kirby game on the GameCube, and it never happened. I know there was Air Ride, but, like, I guess, like, me and my sister never got that game, so, like, yeah. We're supposed to go to Castle, right? Where's the Castle again? From that last cutscene. See, I could, like, talk and commentate while reading cutscenes at the same time. I just had to be, like, very, very, is it not the castle? It looks like a castle to me. What the fuck is it, then? I guess, okay, I guess that's not where I'm supposed to be going. Is it over there, then? Either way, the game's gonna probably tell me where I'm supposed to go exactly. But anyways, yeah, my Wii library was not that much, aside from, like, No More Heroes. Like, that's, like, one of the only third-party games I own. Like, I don't think I've owned... I tried, but the gate's locked, isn't there? Isn't it? Like, that looks like a damn goddamn castle to me! A very humongous, overly exaggerated, overly elaborated castle. But a castle nonetheless, right? Try walking through the gate, nothing happened. Don't try again. There's not even, like, a question mark, question mark, question mark thing. Can't break it open? Is there, like, a secret passageway under there, or...? I don't think so. I had to get to the castle somehow, but how? Is it through here? Is it really through here? I thought... Oh, well, whatever. Maybe it's a different castle I'm thinking of. There was treasure there, so I wanted to get that quickly. Yeah, I... No. Another Nintendo property that I remember playing the shit out of was Punch-Out. I love Punch-Out. I never played the NES version until, like, when I got it at the Wii U eShop, but... And even then, like, the Wii U eShop version I got was for a free game, and it didn't include Mike Tyson, so, like, it wasn't, like, the absolute best version to get. It had Mr. Dream, and I was like, who the fuck is this guy? But yeah, I know that licensing issues and Mike Tyson is not really the most profitable like person nowadays. Speaking of Mike Tyson, have you guys ever watched Ip Man? Oh, ooh, I'm getting comments now. Right. Fuck, okay. Yeah, I remember. These guys, these little fucks are annoying to deal with, so I'm gonna deal with these guys first. Fuck. Come on, I healed. How did that kill? Alright, so yeah. I need to deal with those, like, boomerang leaf guys. Those guys are really annoying to deal with. Anyways, where was I again? God, I think I forgot what I was about to say. I think I was on the topic of Wii games, but, like, I remember something after that. Oh, anyway, speaking of Wii games, yeah. I remember that's when I was like, okay, I got bored of the Wii because, like, there was nothing coming out on the Wii. So I was like, that's when I wanted an Xbox 360. Actually, no, originally I wanted a PS3 because there was, like, a lot more games there, I feel. But the problem was, like, the PS3 was more expensive than an Xbox 360, so I went for the 360 because it was a lot cheaper. Right, this is good enough, right? These are ice enemies, so I can kill them with fire. At least, I assume they are. Yeah, they also drop blizzard too, so they have to be ice enemies. Yeah, so I got bored of my Wii. That's when I got my Xbox 360, and I bought games for that. And they were like, okay, if I want to buy an Xbox 360, what are the games that are, like, good for me to buy? So that's when I picked up Ninja Gaiden. Even though Ninja Gaiden was originally also for the PS3 as well, I got the Xbox 360 version just solely on the fact that it was the uncensored version. I remember, like, I think it was either an IGN or a GameSpot episode or something, or video, some sort of video of that. And I was like, oh, the 360 version is uncensored, I'm gonna get that instead. I also really wanted a PS3 instead of an Xbox 360 solely on the fact that, I think Mortal Kombat, that was when, like, Mortal Kombat was coming out. And I really wanted that game, so I was like, okay, I want the PS3 just for Mortal Kombat, which also included Kratos. Something that the Xbox 360 version didn't have, and it had no exclusive characters, so, like, the 360 version kind of got shafted in that regard. But yeah, I also got Mortal Kombat for the Xbox 360, even though it wasn't exclusive. But yeah. I started out with Ninja Gaiden. Loved the shit out of it. It was a hard fucking game to play with, but I never gave up. Like, it was one of those games that kicked my ass so hard, I wanted to keep trying and trying. Over and over again. So yeah. I guess that's my... that's why I feel like when it comes to, when I say childhood, I'm talking about, like, when I was, like, I guess, like, started video gaming as, like, a 5-year-old towards, like, pre-teen, like, 14 or something like that. That's why I feel like my childhood would probably be, like, anything after that is, like, a little bit, like, I guess it could also classify as my childhood, but, like, not to the same extent as, like, my actual childhood. So, like, I never grew up with any, like, I only got to play Sony games when I was, like, I think 17. Either 17 or 16. 17, 16, or 18. It's, like, one of those numbers. Like, that's when I, like, I think I got, like, my PS3 when I graduated high school. So, yeah, I got into the PlayStation bandwagon pretty late in the game. So, like, unfortunately, I wasn't able to, like, grow up with the likes of, like, Crash Bandicoot. I remember, like, I did grow up with, PlayStation games at a friend's house, but, like, it's not, like, it's mostly due to multiplayer games. It's not, like, one of those games where it's, like, you're so much invested. I feel like with those games, like, I was less inclined to play them. But yeah, I had, like, two other friends that did own an original Xbox, and another friend who owned a PlayStation 2. And that's how I was able to, like, be exposed to, like, PlayStation and Xbox games. Although, to be fair, like, the person that owned a PlayStation 2 was my friend. Never owned RPGs. She was more, like, into, party games, if anything, if that makes sense. There was, like, not a whole lot, though, but, like, I remember Fusion Frenzy being one of them. Like, one of my absolute favorite party games on the PlayStation. Or was that on the Xbox? I don't remember. It was on one of those consoles. Like, I played the shit out of that on my, at a friend's house, and I enjoyed it. But yeah, there was also this, racing game, the Crash Racing game that I also enjoyed. I know, like, people determine, like, Crash Team Racing for the PlayStation 1 the best racing game for a Crash game, though, but I grew up with the original Xbox game. And I still had fun with that game. I guess that was, like, my only experience with a Crash game is the Xbox racing game. That's about it. I'm very much looking forward to the Crash remake that's coming out soon. So, like, if there's any way to, like, get into the Crash bandwagon, I guess it's now, once it's released. I think it's releasing this year, so, like, I don't know if I'm planning on doing a Let's Play of it. If I am, it's probably not going to be released anytime soon, because, or anytime, like, soon from its release date. Like, I want, like, I used to, like, play newly released games immediately and then upload it the same day. Nowadays, I feel like I should not do that, because, like, I want other people to enjoy the game before I do, so it's like, I'll enjoy the game at my own pace, though, and then when the time comes, that's when I'm going to upload my own Let's Play and my experience of the game. Otherwise, like, if you want the game, then, like, I feel like you should have the right to play that game without watching my Let's Play beforehand. Granted, you guys might watch my Let's Play just to see, like, recommendations on what type of games you want to watch. Or what type of games you want to play. I don't know, I feel like you should make your own decision rather than rely on my own opinion to decide whether or not what kind of games. I know, like, there's a lot of Kingdom Hearts fans, especially watching these videos right now, that absolutely, like, love the series, and the only reason why they want to watch my video of it is to see from my perspective what Kingdom Hearts is to me. Sometimes it can be good, sometimes it can be horrifyingly painful, but overall, like, Kingdom Hearts has its own right on my channel. I feel like without it, I wouldn't be myself if it wasn't for the game. But I feel like there are definitely games that are that signify my channel. Originally, I was used to Call of Duty Let's Plays, but no one watched those. So I was like, okay, that's, I gave up on Call of Duty Let's Plays. I was originally, like, had a plan where, like, I was gonna do a Call of Duty game every year. There was, like, a point where, like, one of my friends actually donated to me a Call of Duty game that I could do a Let's Play of. Unfortunately, I have not yet done that. But it was Call of Duty World of War. Assumingly, it was, like, it was not as good at Black Ops, but, like, it was good enough to, like, more than a Let's Play, I feel, and with the oversaturation of Call of Duty, I feel like I'm kind of less inclined to do that, but maybe I should just get back to, like, the old law Call of Duty games. I haven't played Modern Warfare 2 yet, though, but, like, I remember that being, like, one of the best, according to many Call of Duty fans, so maybe? I mean, I do like first-person shooters, like, Overwatch is, like, one of the games that got me back into the first-person shooter genre, even though it's more, like, a MOBA-based type of game, like, you still have, like, that, like, reflex of, like, first-person shooter gameplay, so it's like, okay. This is definitely more, like, my territory, I feel. I guess, like, I wasn't, like, more into, I wasn't, into League of Legends or Dota whatsoever. But Overwatch, on the other hand, because of its, like, genre, I feel I'm more inclined to play that than any other MOBA, I feel. Like, if there was, like, a MOBA for, like, maybe platformers or hack-and-slash games, I'd be like, oh, damn, okay, I'll definitely be up for that, but I have not seen one so far, so there's, yeah. And no, I'm not counting Genji as a hack and slash character. He is way, way too technical to be played as, so it's like, I don't want, Genji is like a cool character to play as, if you can master him, but no, he is very, very technical, and yeah, not only that, but I feel like he's also situational as well. Like, I'm not gonna say he's top tier, like, again, I'm not keeping up with the top tier list, but like, I feel like, in my opinion, Genji is not that strong. Like, he relies way too much on being up close and personal in order to deal the final blows. And this is not just playing as him. I've been able to, like, kill a shit ton of Genjis, like, a lot. The only thing, like, I feel Genjis have an advantage for are, like, turret characters, like, Tor Jorn and Bastion. Those types of characters are easily killed by Genji, because, like, then again, mostly because, like, those are mostly noobs playing those characters, and, like, they think, oh, Bastion, spam the shoot button and camp there is the best way to kill. No, that's not it. That's a good way to defend, but there are certainly a lot of ways around that type of attack, so it's, like, it's not the end-all-be-all strategy to, like, defeating everyone. Oh, Jesus Christ, that scream was really loud.
No! Run!
Oh, hey, it's... Who is she again? Hickory's gonna be pissed if I ever mention her name.
I can feel the light.
What I want to know is, why the hell is Kid Kyrie doing it? I mean, Kid... That kid...
No way I can fight like this.
...doing in this area of the world. Oh, hey, it's...
Hurry.
Mickey Mouse.
Get that girl to someplace that's safe.
Alright.
Who are you? Why do you have a Keyblade?
I'll tell you later. Right now, we gotta stop these things.
Alright. Please tell me I get to play as Mickey Mouse. I doubt it, but... It'll be pretty cool. I got her someplace safe,
everything
by the way.
All right?
Yeah, I hid her next to a bush next to those enemies.
Let's get them.
I don't think that was like a safe place to put a little girl. I mean... You still had to guard her regardless. She could still be in danger from other shadow creatures or heartlesses or unversed enemies that could just spawn out of nowhere, like the ones that we had to face against. Alright, team up with the newcomer and take out all the unversed. Do you honestly expect me not to know who the fuck Mickey Mouse is? Like, even like kids nowadays should know who the hell Mickey Mouse is. If there's like a kid that has no idea, like, he's very iconic, I feel. There's no way. Like, if you're a kid and you didn't grow up with, like... I mean, I didn't grow up with, like, Disney and all that, though. But, like, I was able to, like, at least recognize who the hell, like, Mickey Mouse is. I'm not like, oh, who's that cute little mouse? I have no idea who he is. Like, you have to know him. I mean, I could be wrong. There could be, like, a rural... Oh, fuck, no, not these enemies. No. Actually, no, fuck, I have an idea. Let me just heal myself first real quickly. Okay. That's one way, I guess. Fuck these enemies. Fuck these enemies so much. These are the worst. I'm not even hitting them, am I? God damn, okay. I don't think I hit them at all. Alright, hopefully that's good enough. It's hitting them, I think. Alright, how about now? I think it's good enough to kill at least one. And then... Oh, I was hoping to for the projectile attack to come out so that I don't have to worry about that later on. That's fine. Alright. Very good. But yeah, I feel like characters like Mickey Mouse, Super Mario... Like, those types of characters, they're very iconic. Like, if you don't know them... Then... I don't know, it could be like you're like living in a rural area, and you have no- Whoa, what the fuck is this? Is the power of darkness? What's it doing? What the fuck? Ow. Oh, I think it was like that clock at me. No. Oh, that is a parry. Cause like, usually that attack, like just do it once, but like, I'm guessing if I get attacked again, I could just parry- Okay! I should definitely use that move more often in case like I don't want to get hit by any enemies. Get back here, asshole. Alright, maybe that could help with the projectiles, although like it didn't work with the fire breath, but that might be a boss character. I'm not sure if it works against projectiles, but we'll see. Is this a homing attack? Yay, I'm doing something, I'm not sure what exactly I'm doing, but okay. There are no enemies nearby, so what was the point of that? Oh yeah, I got better high jump. Yay. There we go. Anyone else? Nope, one more. Fuck it. It's a homing attack, so it should. It's not gonna kill, but like, do silly some damage. Come on, get the fuck back here. Yo. There we go. Yeah. Maybe I just talk about, like, random shit. Like, not just necessarily, like, I'm all about opinions, so I guess, like, just expressing what I think is my best forte in commentary.
My name is Aqua.
Like, people...
I train under Master Eric.
People make jokes.
And I'm Mickey.
People are focused.
I used to be Yen's apprentice. I came back to him
I'm more like a... I guess just an opinionated person.
I sense light within this girl. You think that's why they attacked her?
Yep. I think you might be absolutely right. If you ask me, she must be somebody pretty extraordinary.
Yes, I'm quite certain she's someone we're supposed to protect.
What, you're saying she can't fight either? Come on.
Oh no, not now.
What's going on? Oh, because I'm guessing his teleporter things just act out of, like, impulse. So I saw something about Yen Sid for a second. Oh, thanks, little girl.
Are these for me?
I picked you some flowers. Thank you for saving me.
Oh, they're lovely. You're so sweet.
My name's Kairi. Nice to meet you.
Okay, so it is Kairi. Nice, it's not one of those, too. Like, characters that I'm look awkward. Like Kairi, but are actually
Kairi,
have completely different names.
Kairi!
Oh, Grandma!
She has a fucking grandma?!
Just a minute.
Bad touch! She's touching her...
I just cast a magic spell on you. One day, when you're in trouble, the light within you will lead you to the light of another. Someone to keep you safe.
Thanks!
I was kind of expecting that cutscene to occur maybe in Destiny Island or something.
Okay. Oh. Bye!
Yeah, Kairi has a fucking grandma? I thought, like... Like,
hey,
it's never...
Grandma?
Hmm? What is it?
Could you tell me that story?
Again, dear?
Please?
Very well, then. Long ago, people lived in peace, bathed in the warmth.
Unless, like, Kairi is,
everyone,
like, one of those, like, characters that was never born in Destiny Island, just somehow brought there.
Then, people began to fight.
I don't know.
It.
Maybe it might have been explained in the previous Kingdom Hearts game.
And darkness
but,
was
yeah.
born in their hearts. The darkness spread, swallowing the light in many people's hearts. It covered everything, and the world disappeared. But small fragments of light survived in the hearts of children. With these fragments of light,
Aquarius is like eavesdropping or something.
World. It's the world we live in now. But the true light sleeps deep within the darkness. That's why the worlds are still scattered, divided from each other. But someday, a door to the innermost darkness will open, and the true light will return. So, listen, child.
So that's
even
basically opening Kingdom
darkness,
Hearts.
Darkness, there will always be a light to guide you. Believe in the light, and the darkness will never defeat you.
Like, I don't have
your
like anything against it.
Shine with its power,
the ideologies of light and darkness.
Push the darkness away.
Like, it's very heavily,
Kairi,
what's the word? Pounded?
Something tells me I didn't run into her by accident.
But yeah, oh, that's weird, like, Aqua met Kairi, Terra met, who the
fuck first, it never ends!
Oh, that's a boss battle, anyways, Terra met, Riku. How come Vent has never met Sora? That's what I'm wondering. But then again, Ventus has more relation towards, like, Roxas than Sora, I feel. So, I don't know. I don't know. Maybe Kairi and Riku are meant to be, and my one true pairing of Sora and Riku will never come to fruition. Mon Square? Yippee. That? Wait a minute. Is that supposed to be, why is it like that? What purpose does that... Is it to, like, water the trees? To have, like, rain in case there's no natural rain coming down? That looks a little bit, weird, like, aesthetically it looks nice, but, like, the sprouting water just feels like you're wasting water. Wasn't there some sort of item? Yes, there is. How do I get to it? Not even my high jump is... Oh, never mind. My high jump is high enough. Okay. 25 minutes. That should be good enough to take a break. So, we'll be right back with the next episode of Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep.